Hello friends, let us see the classification of signals in details. I am Santosh Kale, Assistant Professor, College of Engineering, Malegaon, BK Baramati. We know that signal can be classified into different types: continuous time and discrete time signals, deterministic and non-deterministic signals, periodic and aperiodic signals, even and odd signals, energy and power signals. In the last screencast, we have seen what is continuous time and discrete time, deterministic and non-deterministic signal, periodic and aperiodic signal. Now let us see what is even and odd functions. As shown in the figure, if the function g of t, this is equal to g of minus t, then given function is said to be even function. Or x of t, this is equal to x of minus t, if this condition is satisfied, then given signal is called as continuous time signal, or it may be called as symmetrical signals. We know that x of t can represent value of a signal for positive t, and x of minus t can represent value of a signal for negative t. So you can see in the figure, this is the condition for even functions. And if you consider g of t, this is equal to minus g of minus t, then given function is said to be odd function. Or x of t, this is equal to minus x of minus t, then given signal is called as odd signal, or it may be called as anti-symmetric signals. Even signal, it is called as symmetric signals. Now the even and odd part of a functions. The even part of a functions can be written as ge of t, this is equal to g of t plus g of minus t upon 2. You can easily write the even part, or you can easily separate the even part and odd part from a signal. So odd part can be expressed as g o of t, this is equal to g of t minus g of minus t upon 2. Function whose even part is 0 is odd, and the function whose odd part is 0 called as even function. Now let us see the various combinations of even and odd functions. Let us consider if we have both the signals are even signals, and if you perform the sum operation, then the resultant signal is even signal. If we have both the even signals and if you perform difference operation, then the resultant signal is even signal. If you perform the product of both the even signal, then product is even. And if you perform the division operation, then division operation of both the even signals, then you can get the quotient even. If you consider both the functions or both the signals are odd, and if you perform the sum operation, then you can get resultant function as odd. If you perform difference of two odd functions, you can get resultant signal odd. If you perform product of two odd functions, then the resultant function is even. And if you perform the division of two odd signals, then quotient is even. If you consider one signal is even and another signal is odd, and if you perform the sum operation, then you can't get the neither even nor odd functions. For difference, also same condition, but for the product, you can get the resultant signal is odd, and if you perform the division, then you can get the resultant signal is quotient, you can get odd. Next, the derivatives and integral of a functions. If you consider the function type, it is even, its derivative is odd, and if you obtain the integral of even function, then you can get the resultant signal is odd plus some constant term. if the function type it is odd, and if you perform the derivative operation on it, then you can get the resultant signal even. And if you integrate the odd function, then you can get the resultant signal even. Next it is discrete time even and odd signals. So according to the continuous time, only the t variable get changed by n variable. So for the even functions, g of n, this is equal to g of minus n, as shown in this figure, represent the even function. So even part of a discrete time signal can be represented as ge of n, this is equal to g of n plus g of minus n upon 2. In the similar way, if g of n equal to minus g of minus n, if this condition is satisfied, then a given discrete time signal is called as odd function. As shown in the figure, this is the odd function. It is shown the odd function can be expressed as g o of n, this is equal to g of n minus g of minus n upon 2. So this is all about the even and odd functions of discrete time signal. Now let us see the combinations of even and odd functions for discrete time signal. If we have both the function type is even, and if you perform the different operation like sum, difference, product and quotient, then the sum of both the even function is even, difference of both the even function is even, product of both the even function is even, and if you perform the division operation of both the even signal, then quotient is even. If both the signals are odd, and if you perform the sum operation, then you can get resultant signal is odd. If you perform the difference of two odd functions, then the resultant signal is odd. If both the functions are odd, and if you perform product operation, then the resultant signal is even. If you perform the division operation, then the quotient is even. If one of the signal is even and another signal is odd, and if you perform the sum operation, then there may be chances of to get the even or odd function. For the difference also, same criteria, you can get the even or odd as a resultant signal. But if one signal is even and one signal is odd, and if you perform the product operation, then you can get the resultant signal is odd. If you perform the division operation, then you can get quotient as a odd. Next, product of discrete time even and odd functions. Let us see in this figure, two discrete time signals are shown and both the signals are even signals. If you multiply them, then you can get the resultant signal, which is also even in nature. Let us consider, if one signal is even and another signal is odd, if you multiply them, this is the loop of multiplication of one signal is even and another signal is odd. Next, we have to prove these examples that the product of two even signal is even. You have to prove it. Take both the signals are even, and then you can easily prove it. If you consider two odd signal, just perform the product, and just you have to prove it that the resultant signal is odd. If one signal is even and another signal is odd, and prove it, what is the resultant signals. Let us see if both the functions are odd functions. So this is the resultant signals after multiplication of both the odd functions. Now the next type of a signal, it is energy and power signal. Now let us see the definition of energy signal. So signal with finite energy and zero power is called as energy signal. So for an energy signal, it is available in between 0 to infinity, and power is 0. So signal energy of a signal is defined as the area under the square of magnitude of the signal. So it can be expressed as Ex, this is equal to integration minus infinity to plus infinity mod of x of t square into dt. The unit of signal energy depends on the unit of the signal. Now let us see what is power signal. We know that some signals have infinite signal energy. For the power signals, the power signal can be expressed in between 0 to infinity, and for the power signal energy is infinite. So average power of the signal can be expressed as Px, this is equal to limit t tends to infinity 1 upon t integration minus t upon 2 to plus t upon 2 mod of x of t square into dt. For a periodic signal, x of t is the average signal power, and it can be expressed as Px, this is equal to 1 upon capital T integration over the period capital T mod of x of t square into dt, where capital T is any period of the signal. So basically periodic signals are power signals. Next, the discrete time signal with finite energy and zero power is called as energy signals. So for the discrete time, energy is available or can be expressed in between 0 to infinity and power is 0. So the signal energy for a discrete time signal x of n can be expressed as Ex, this is equal to summation n varies from minus infinity to plus mod of x of n square. If you consider the discrete time signal, so the power of a discrete time signal can be expressed as Px, this is equal to limit n tends to infinity 1 upon 2 times of n summation n varies from minus n to n minus 1 mod of x of n square. If you consider the periodic signal, average power can be expressed as Px, this is equal to 1 upon n summation for all the values of n mod of x of n square. So summation n equal to capital N means the sum over any set of consecutive n's is exactly equal to capital N in length. Let us see one example. X of t equal to e raised to minus 2t into e of t, and you have to find whether this signal is energy signal or power signals. So it is expressed as x of t, this is equal to e raised to minus 2t, and it is multiplied with unit step signal. So it is present from 0 to plus t. You can set the limit. We have the formula. You can put all the values in this formula. If you simplify it, you can get 0 to t e raised to minus 2t square into dt. So this is equal to e raised to minus 4t into dt. If you apply the integration, then you can get e raised to minus 4t upon minus 4 over the limit 0 to plus t. If you simplify it, then you can get 1 upon 4 minus e raised to minus 4t upon 4. Now let us find out what is the energy of signal and what is power of signal. So we have equation for energy of the signal. This is equal to limit t tends to infinity integration minus t to plus t mod of x of t square into dt. So let us have this answer to this limits, and if you solve it, you can get 1 upon 4 joules as an energy. Now to find out the power, let us write down first of all the formula of the power. Put all the values, you can get the answer 0. And finally we can conclude that energy is constant and power is 0. Therefore the given signal is energy signal. Thank you very much. Next part we will see in the next screencast. Thank you.